वेल फ्रेंड्स, आई एम मिस्टर राहुल, योर इंग्लिश टीचर. लास्ट टाइम वी हैव लर्न वन पोएम, दैट इज हाउ टू टेल वाइल्ड एनिमल्स. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न वन लेसन, दैट इज विल सी द नेम ऑफ द लेसन आफ्टरवर्ड्स. यू आर राइट नाउ एट योर होम, यू आर एंजॉइंग योर हॉलीडेज, बट एग्जैक्टली यू आर नॉट एंजॉइंग बिकॉज यू लाइक टू लिव इन स्कूल. बिकॉज सिंस मेनी ईयर्स यू आर इन स्कूल, सिंस यूर नर्सरी क्लासेस यू आर इन स्कूल एंड नाउ यू आर इन 10th स्टैंडर्ड. सो इट्स वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ईयर इन your perspective. You want to gain some certain good marks and you want to show that you are very talented boys and girls, and that is why you are feeling very uncomfortable at your home, because you are learning from a home, but you are taking good interest in learning. The school time is always very great. It's a divine time, because here we get different kinds of people. You will get different friends who has different nature, who find you find yourself in a very comfortable atmosphere where we can you can make fun, you can have friendship with your friends, you can play with your friends, and many more things you do with your friends. And that is why we can say that this school time is always very divine. And when if we grown older, then we always remember that school time, which is really very that we can say divine one, and we would like to remember it again and again. I also remember my school time, because it is really golden period of our life. So when we come to school, why we enjoy the school? If you ask the question, why we enjoy the school, or why we enjoy the school life? So surely you will say that we are away from the parents, we will not get that scolding at home, because when we are at home, then we get the scolding of father and mother. We get the warning, do study and all these things, do some household work and all. But in school, we get different kind of people, different kind of friends, and we enjoy the company of the friends. We come here, we enjoy, we make bully also. There are certain boys and girls who make fun of others. And even though we don't participate in that, but we enjoy that. But is it good to make bully on others, make fun of others? Certainly no. If we make fun of others and if we hurt them, it is what we can say, it is a sin. Because hurting others or make someone cry is not that good, as we are human being. So one question I want to ask here, why, how you will make the friendship? If you want to make a friendship with one of the boy or girl, how can you make? What are the criteria for you? Is it like that because he or she look good or beautiful, that is why? Or it is like many different things which they have. Suppose somebody has antique piece, like I have certain different things, like different paints, I have certain good thing which you don't have, that is why you will make friendship. Or we can say belongs to rich family. This may be not in our area, but certain teenagers make friendship because someone is belongs to a rich family, that is why they make the friendship. Is it like that for you, that belongs to a rich family, then only you will make the friendship? Is it like that? Or having good number of friends? So suppose you will see that this particular boy is there or girl is there who has many number of friends, that is why I have to make friendship with him or her, like that. Or having good nature. I think this is the last thing which I have told, that is having good nature will promote you to make friendship with her or him, because you are very great, I know that. But is it good that to all these four or five things which I have told earlier, good looking or many different things which they have, belong to rich family, having good number of friends, will be the good criteria to make friendship? Certainly no. That we must make the friendship with the any boy or girl which has certain good nature. So we'll see in this lesson what exactly happened with the one girl. The author, or the, we can say author of the this lesson is the 100 dresses, is L. Bessor Esther, who born in 1906 and died in 1988. Actually, she has written many things, many written work only for the small kids. So she is really well known for writing lesson, realizing some stories, writing some novels for the small children. And this particular lesson which he has written, this particular extract he has written in a guild. We'll see that what, why exactly. Because she was also one of the student in her academic year, in her childhood, and she has seen certain things happen very badly with one of the one of her classmates, and she couldn't go against those who were making fun of that particular girl, and that is why that guilt was there in her in her mind throughout the life, and that is why she wanted to you know, express that guilt in form of her writing, and she has written this particular extract, or we can say the story. So this is one of the story which is based on the reality, real account of her life, her Miss Esther's life we are going to see. So first of all, what is the background of this lesson? We will see you know, there are certain, this story is a sensitive account of how a poor young girl is judged by her classmate. Actually, we often fail, sometimes we fail to identify some of the student. Maybe a certain boy or girl has not good clothes, not good tiffin box, not good things. Then we feel that he is not in my category, so I will not make friendship with her or him. In our school, this never happens, but in other school. So in this school, what exactly happened? That one girl belongs to, not belongs to her in their own country. That is why, sorry, that is why they give her very very panic, we can say, very not very good behavior, not good, not very good treatment to her. And that all we will see in this story, and how at the end that girl win the hearts of many, that we are going to learn. So background of this, the first Polish immigrants America in 1608. So in America, many people have immigrated. Immigrated means what? Came from their own country to America in 1608. But the largest wave of Polish immigration occurred in the early 20th century, when more than 1 million Poles migrated to the United States. The Polish state did not exist at the time, and immigrants were identified according to their country of origin rather than the ethnicity. So actually, from the Poland is the country, from there many people have come in America, means USA, and these are called Poles. And again, many from the many countries people also have come from their country to America. So they were, have been called like Russian Poles. Russian Poles means what? The people, those who have come from Russia, they are called Russian Poles. Then German Poles, the people or the citizen of Germany have come from Germany to America, they have called German Poles. And people who came from Australia called Austrian Poles. So this was the background, and that is why, and they have belonged to other country, that is why they haven't got that good treatment from the native of America. Now, one of the most notable Polish American communities in the Chicago and its suburb. Suburb means what? We can say suburb means outside of the city, that area of the outside of the city. Chicago is sometimes called the second largest Polish city of the world. Actually, Poland means people, Pole people from Poland. And what is the capital of Poland? Warsaw is the capital of Poland. So how many people, population of the Pole people in Warsaw, because Warsaw is the capital of Poland, and how many population is there in Warsaw, means the next number is in the Chicago, because that many people have, are there in the Chicago in America. So by this we can understand how many people have come from Poland to America. Okay, and the last one we will see that what is the background. Polish Americans were sometimes discriminated against the United States, as they were Irish, Italians and Jews, because they have come from the other country. That is why the treatment which was given by the American people was not that good. For example, suppose some people who comes from other country, we become so polite with them because we have certain good nature, we have certain good, what we can say, our culture, that Atithi Devo Bhava, right? So guest is a god in our country. That is why we give very great treatment to those people, those who come from the other country. But this is not the case in other countries, that they, those people really not give good treatment to the migrant or immigrant people in their country. And that is why those people, like Irish people, Italian people and Jewish people have come in America. So they didn't get that good treatment. And according to the United States of States, 2000 census, we can say around 1.4% of the population of the America was speaking Poland language. So by this we can understand how many people have immigrated from Poland to America, but they didn't get that good treatment from the American citizen. So now exactly we will learn the lesson. So before learning the lesson, we will understand some of the character of the lesson. So we will see that there are mainly three characters in the story, in the lesson, the 100 races. First one is Vanda Petronsky, second one is Peggy, and third one is Maddie. So those three are the girls, and they are going in the same school. Vanda Petronsky is the protagonist of this story, who is the main character, then Peggy and the Maddie. Vanda Petronsky has come from the Poland, and that is why she is an immigrant, and she has got very very bad treatment in the school. Not exactly very bad, but she has got indifferent treatment in the school. Peggy is one of the girl who is looking so beautiful. She has curly hair, and around almost a whole class, maximum students are praising her, appreciating her all the time. Maddie is also quite kind of a poor girl who used to revolve around the Peggy. Maddie always lives with the help of the Peggy. So she couldn't say anything, even though Peggy will do something wrong, but Maddie has to keep shut her mouth. So Vanda Petronsky is a quite different name, because she does not belong to America, and that is why she has got very bad treatment in the America. And that is what she's kind of girl that who is looking so quiet. She never trouble others. She always sit at the second last bench in the class. Even though she is very smart, she is very good. She is good in academic also, but she sits at the back or second row. Even though she is not notorious, actually what we see, those who are sitting at the back bench are very notorious. They wanted to make fun in the class, and those who are sitting in the front bench, they are very sincere. But this is not the case in the matter of Vanda Petronsky. And Vanda Petronsky is a name, very funny name. It was not that usual in America. That is why she used to get very bad treatment. Peggy was the really native of the America, so she was very dominating in her class. Maddie, we can say, kind of girl who was totally depend on the Peggy. We'll see that exactly what happens in the lesson. Today, Monday, Vanda Petronsky was not in her seat, but nobody, not even Peggy and Madeline, the girl who started all the fun, noticed her absence. Usually Vanda sat in the seat next to the last seat in the last row in the room number 13. She sat in the corner of the room where the rough boys who did not make good marks sat, the corner of the room where there was moose scuffling. Scuffling means scuffling of feet. Moose roars of laughter when anything funny was said, and moose mud and dirt on the floor. So in this paragraph, what exactly writer want to say here? The exactly arrangement of the class. So where exactly Vanda used to sit? Second last bench in the class. But today was Monday, and Vanda was not there, but nobody noticed. It is very, you know, painful thing. One of our friend is not in the class, but we don't have that sympathy for him, that why he didn't come, why he didn't come. Anything wrong happened with him or not? That we have to think. Then only we are quite good as a human being. But that was not the case here in this class. So nobody, not even Peggy and Madeline, even though Peggy and Madeline was her good friends, but they didn't bother about this. They didn't think why she hadn't come. And Peggy and Madeline, the girls who started all the fun, noticed her absence. And you know, they, as usual, they come, they started fun and all. So they didn't notice what, why she didn't come and all these things. Usually Vanda sat in the next, next to the last seat in the last row in the room number 13. Actually, their class was in a room number 13. So it is explained here. She sat in the corner of the room where the rub boys means those who are not interested in the study, those were sitting there. And those of that kind of boys or girls, we can say, those who were not earning good marks, scoring good marks. And it was the most noisy place in the class. It is given here one scuffling. Scuffling means what? Noisy, dragging movement of the feet of the ground. You know that certain, suppose somebody crack any joke and, you know, in a silence that we see that somebody crack any joke and certain boys and girls are making fun. They laugh. And those who are sitting at the front bench, they don't listen that, they don't pay attention towards that, they pay attention towards the teacher. And that back benchers are making fun, they are doing their own business. But even though Vanda was sitting at the second half bench, but she was not that kind of girl who used to come to make fun or enjoy the other atmosphere. No, she was very absolutely fine, she was very fine. She was absolutely sincere girl, but due to her certain limitations, or we can say some miserability, that is why she used to sit at the second last bench. And the atmosphere of the last bench was very roaring and laughter and all the time, most of the time, and dirt was there at that particular place. So at that place she was sitting. Peta did not sit there because she was rough and noisy. No, on the contrary, she was very quiet girl. Actually, where we used to sit, where we feel that, okay, this is my comfortable zone. So my friends will make some certain, you know, joke, they will crack the joke and I will laugh. So I will not get bored in the whole day. So I used to miss, basically, usually, student used to select those places to sit. Some student go to the very first bench, so that they cannot get distracted by the other student. So it is the opinion, this is the strategy of the everybody, and like that they were sitting. But she was sitting at the second last bench, but she was not that kind of girl to make fun or distract herself. There are certain thing which was in her mind, that is why she was sitting there. Nobody knew exactly why Vanda sat in the seat. Unless it was because she came all the way from the Boggins height and her feet were usually kicked in the dry mud. That was her tragedy. She used to come by the Boggins height. That area is not that good. This is not the where she used to live. That was not the good area to live. There was a certain mud on the road, and when she used to come from that particular road, she used to get all sandals and shoes muddy with the mud. But no one really thought much about Vanda Petronsky once she sat in the corner of the room. And once she sits, she never used to go out and all. And that is why she used to sit there, because her totally sandals and shoes were covered with the mud. The time when they thought about Vanda was out of the school hours. Actually, when she was sitting in the classroom that time, nobody was thinking about her. But when she used to go out of the class sometimes, that time they were thinking about the Vanda. At noon time when they were coming back to school, so when they used to when they used to talk with the Vanda, when while coming in the school or while going from the school or in the noon time. When groups of two or three or even more would be talking and laughing on their way to the schoolyard. Now when we get recess, what we do? We just complete our tiffin very quickly and we go and chit chat with our friends. We make fun, we talk about others, we make gossiping also. That all things he was that time they used to talk with the Vanda. So we can understand by this that Vanda was not that important person, was not important girl or student in the class. that someone will go specially and will talk with her. What was the reason? She was very poor. She was coming with the muddy leg, and she was not from their own country. Her name was also very different, Vanda Petronsky, and their name belongs to American native. Then sometimes they waited for Vanda to have fun with her. Actually, why we wait for our friend? Because we have certain sympathy, we have certain attachment with the friend. That is why we wait. But they were waiting for the Vanda because they can get chance to make fun of her. This was a very very bad thing, we can understand. The next day, Tuesday, Vanda was not in school either. Monday, she was not there. On Tuesday also, she was not there. Nobody noticed her absence again because she was not that important girl in the class. So it was not so good. It is really very painful that one of the classmates of our class is not there for last 2 days, but nobody noticed that she hasn't come. Why she hasn't come? Nobody bothered about that. It was very great. It was very great pain for me and all you all. But on Wednesday, Peggy and Maddie, who sat down from front with other children who got good marks and who didn't track in the whole lot of mud, did notice that Vanda wasn't there. Peggy was the most popular girl in the school. So we can understand by this paragraph that Peggy was very beautiful girl and Vanda was not that good because she was belongs to very poor family and she was emigrant, or she has migrated from the Poland to America. And she used to come with the mud, and she was not that. Peggy was very high class girl, so she used to come with a great you can say great mannerism. Okay. Peggy was the most popular girl in the school. She was pretty, she had many pretty clothes, and you know that this is today's era that we are recognized by our outer appearance. Nobody think about how you are, how is your nature, but what other things? What is the first medium for the having friendship or having relationship, good relationship? How you look or how you wear, what you wear, that all things are there. And she was very pretty, she had many pretty clothes and her hair was curly. Maddie was her close friend. The reason Peggy and Maddie noticed Vanda's absence was because Vanda had made them late to school. Now you will think how Vanda make her late to school. We'll see. They had waited for Vanda to have some fun with her and she just hadn't come. Why? Because they wanted certain things to make fun. They wanted to make themselves very happy. And how they were making themselves happy? By making fun on Vanda. And that is why they were waiting and they were coming late in the school. And 2 days they were waiting for the Vanda, but she didn't come. And that is why they also become late, because they came late because she didn't come. They often waited for Vanda Petronsky to have fun with her. It's very very bad thing that we are just utilizing our time to make fun of others, to hurt others. So it was that the case why they were coming late. And only for that matter they used to talk with the Vanda. Otherwise they don't have any interest. They wouldn't have any interest to talk with Vanda. Vanda Petronsky, most of the children in the room 30 didn't have a name like that because, as usual, you know very well that because she was not belong to their own country and it was the name belong to Poland, and that is Petronsky was not as usual name for them. And most of the children in the room 13 did not have names like that. They had names easy to say like Thomas, Smith, Alan. So these are their native names, and they used to have certain familiarity with those names, like in our India, like Suresh, Ramesh, Lalita, Sunita. Nowadays some good names also are there. We see some movies, we see some serials, daily soap serials, and the name which we like and that we keep to our younger one, and that is why like that. And we never keep the name to our relative like Thomas or Charles or Hooper like that. No, we never, because this is not from our country, this is not our culture. Like that, Petronsky is not the good name for their point of view. That is why they haven't, because Petronsky, the name belongs to Poland, Okay, those people might put the name or keep the name of their younger one. So what was the like name, like Thomas, Smith or Alan? There was one boy named Bounce. So Bounce was the name, and Willy Bounce, and people thought that was funny, but not funny in the same way that Petrovsky was. And there was also one boy whose name was Bounce, but they compared with Petrovsky with the Bounce, and they feel that all the students felt that Petrovsky is much funnier or funnier than Bounce. Svenda did not have many friends, any friends. He came to school alone and went home alone. This is the regular routine of the Vanda. She always wore faded blue dresses. Faded means what? It is given here. Faded means dim color, old. By this, we can understand when someone is wearing very old costume, or we can say dress, then we can understand that she belongs to very poor family. Faded dress that didn't hang right. It was clean. But what is the most important thing? It was very clean. It was not new dress, but it was very, very clean. But it looked as though it had never been ironed properly. The person who belongs to very poor family, how can he iron his clothes? So soon he see neighbor iron her clothes. Sometimes they surrounded her. She did not have many friends, but a lot of girls talked to her. You see, this is one thing by we can understand that she had good nature. She had not many friends because she belongs to very poor family. Second thing is not that. See, she is native from the Poland, not from the America. So she didn't have that good number of friends. But many students were talking to her. It means that her nature was good. They surrounded her in the schoolyard as she stood watching the little girls play hopscotch. Hopscotch means a game in which children hop into an over square mark on the ground. This is one kind of game. That time she used to see that horoscope on the worn hard ground. Vanda, Peggy would say in the most courteous manner. And that time Peggy used to be very dominating girl in the class. She used to Vanda, Peggy said in a most courteous manner, as though she were talking to Miss Mason. Mason is the teacher. And how we talk with the teacher? Very politely, very courteous manner, very in a proper way, modest way. Like this he used to go. She would say, giving one of her friends nudge. Nudge means what? Very gentle touch, like this. You know that when we want to make fun of others, and when we want that somebody should listen how I am making fun of others. That time how we attract others by giving nudge. Nudge means very gentle push. Tell us, Jesse. Yeah, Peggy is asking to Vanda. Tell us, how many dresses did you say you had hanging up in your closet? How many dresses you have in your closet? 100, Vanda, you would say. 100, exclaim all the girls incredulously. Incredulously showing unwillingness to believe. Is it possible? Because she belongs to very, very poor family, and how she would have 100 dresses? And the little ones would stop playing hotspots and listen. You know that this is a very fantastic thing, that suppose somebody is making fun on others, and then we forget all the work and we just join that. Is it good? So the person who is making fun also criminal, we can say, is also not that good boy or good girl. And those who are just standing and watching and listening, that also are the similar kind of people, we can say, because one should not hurt others, one should not make someone cry. Yeah, 100 all line up, and Vanda said. Vanda then her thin lip drew together in silence. What are they like? All silk, I bet, said Peggy. And again very cunningly she asked, all are from by six or silk, all are made up of silk, I bet. Surely it will be. Yeah, all silk, all colors. Velvet too. Yeah, velvet too. 100 dresses, Vanda would repeatedly solidly. Solidly means what? Not showing any feeling. She said very normally that, yes, I have 100 dresses in my closet. And some of silk and some of velvet. And then before she would go on very far, they couldn't help bursting into shriek and peals of laughter. And as she will go little away from that group, Then all the girls which were gathered together, which would be gathered together, they were laughing very loudly. 100 dresses, obviously the only dresses Vanda had was the blue one she wore every day. And the fact was that they knew since many days she used to wear only one dress. And that is why they were not believing on Vanda. So why did she say she had 100? A story. And suppose one doesn't have that dresses, that number of dresses, then one should not say like that. That is, Peggy was not that bad girl. She was not having that bad nature, but she had, maybe we can understand that she has certain nature who didn't like saying lie. So maybe she understood that she belongs to a very poor family, and why she is telling that she has 100 dresses. And then again, how many shoes did you say you had? 60 pairs, all line up in my closet. Cried with exaggeration, politeness, greeted these all alike. Oh no, every pair is different, all colors, all line up. Again, she might have asked one question to Vanda, how many shoes you have? She said that I have 60 pairs. Also not that digestible, it is hyperbole we can say. One would have around 2 to 3 set of your shoes or sandals. But she said I have 60 pairs. It is also exaggeration for the girl's point of view. Peggy, who had thought of this game, and Maddie, her inseparable friend. And Peggy used to ask the same question to her, and she used to give the same answer. And at that time, who was accompanying Peggy? The Maddie, we can say. So another character, Maddie was, Madeline was the inseparable friend of Peggy. Friend, we always the last to live. And then after that, after making fun, they, Miss Peggy and Maddie, was the last to go home. Finally, Vanda would move up the street, her eyes dull and her mouth closed. Then hitchhiking for his given her, is catching. Catching her left shoulder every now and then in the funny way she had. Finishing the walk to school alone. And it was very tragic seeing that she used to go alone and she used to come alone. Peggy was not really cruel. She protected small children from bullies. So as I told you that Peggy was not that wicked girl. She was not that cruel. But she might have certain opposition for the liar. And she cried for... So we can understand by this paragraph, Peggy was not that cruel girl. She protected small children from bullies. Bully means those who have a very wicked nature. And she cried for hours if she saw an animal mistreated. If any animal she found that mistreated by someone else or some other animals, she used to cry for hours. So that much sentimental Peggy was. But in this case, she was really very rude, we can say. She was just making fun of Vanda. At that time, she didn't cry. It means that she was very indifferent in this situation. Don't you think that this is cruel way to treat Vanda? She would have been very surprised. Cruel. Why did the girl say she had 100 dresses? So one should not say lie. That is why she might have the question. Why did the girl say that she had 100 dresses? Anybody could tell that was a lie. Now, why did she want to lie? And suppose she didn't have that many dresses, then she should not lie about that. And she wasn't just an ordinary person. Else why did she have a name like that? Anyway, they never made her cry. But she used to make fun of her, but she never made her cry. At the end, we can say Vanda used to be very quiet and she used to go alone in a very funny way. And after that, these two, Miss Maddie and Peggy, used to go home or in school. But these two girls never made her to cry. As for Maddie, this business was asking Vanda every day how many dresses and how many hats and how many this and that she had was bothering her. And Maddie was very inseparable partner of Peggy. And that is, and used to listen every day that Peggy used to ask how many dresses you have, how many hats you have, how many sandals you have. That was not that good for her, for Maddie. She used to be get panicked with those questions, but she couldn't ask Peggy. Maddie was also a very poor girl. Why she didn't ask? Because Maddie was also a very poor girl. She used to depend on Peggy, and that is why she don't want to break the relationship with the Peggy. Maybe Peggy will target her after the Wanda. So she used to be very scared with those things. She usually move over somebody's hand me on down close. Thank goodness she didn't live up on Boggins side or have a funny name. Now Maddie is thinking to herself that thank God she is not living in the Boggins side, or she doesn't have that funny name like the Wanda Petronsky. So she was thinking that I am really very grateful to God. I am really very thankful that I don't have such a suburb name, and I am not living in that suburb area which belongs to very poor family, and I am not immigrated also. Sometimes when Peggy was asking Wanda those questions in that mocking polite voice, Maddie felt embarrassed. I studied the marbles in the palm of her hand. And sometimes when Peggy used to ask, remind her the question like how many days you have and all, that time she didn't listen that way properly, and she becomes so embarrassed. She becomes so uneasy. She feel very uneasy in that particular time. Not that she felt sorry for Wanda exactly. She would never have paid any attention to Wanda if Peggy hadn't invented the traces game. But suppose Peggy and all the other started on her neck, she wasn't as poor as Wanda. And she was really scared. Why? Because she's also very poor. I mean, like Wanda was poor, like similar way, Maddie also was very poor. So she didn't have raised her voice. She didn't have raised her voice. Still, she would not like for them to begin on her. She wished Peggy would stop teasing Wanda Petronsky. But she was very normal girl. She was very good natured girl. That is why she wished that Peggy should stop teasing Wanda Petronsky, because she was not bearing that. Who was not? Maddie was not that good. Maddie was not that good to listen all these things, because she was troubling. It was troubling to her, to whom? Maddie, that Peggy was teasing Wanda Petronsky. Now we'll see that today, even though they had been late to school, Maddie was glad she had not had to make fun of Wanda. She worked her arithmetic problems absent-mindedly. And today also Maddie was late, but see why, you know that earlier we have discussed that Peggy and Maddie was used to be late because they used to make fun of Miss Peggy, not Maddie. Peggy used to make fun of Wanda. But today Maddie was late to school because she has certain homework to do, and that is she was completing her arithmetic problems absent-mindedly, because one thing was there in her mind that Peggy is troubling Wanda Petronsky, and that was troubling her now and then, every now and then. And today she is really very thankful that she hadn't got time, or she was not with the Peggy to trouble Wanda Petronsky. So let's see, and she was just doing something like arithmetic problem. She wish she had a nerve means courage to write Peggy's a note, and she wanted, she wished that she must have get that courage to write something to Peggy that she should not tease her and all. Hey Peggy, and she has written, she started to write, hey Peggy, let's stop asking Wanda how many dresses she has. When she finished her arithmetic, she did started a note to Peggy. Suddenly she paused and shuddered. She scared. She wanted to write something to Peggy, not to trouble by the question how many dresses you have to Wanda Petronsky. But she shuddered with some certain things. She pictured herself in the yard, a new target for Peggy and the girls. Now you know very well that Maddie is totally dependent on the Peggy. That is why if she would write like that later to Peggy, Peggy will take the revenge, and she will be like Wanda was getting treated like that. Maddie also be will get treated by the Peggy and other girls. That is why she shuddered with that. She scared with the thought. And Peggy might ask her where she got the dresses and she had on. And because Peggy used to give her old dresses to Maddie, and she might ask the question in front of many girls that where do you get those dresses? and that will be insulting feeling for her. That is why she didn't. And then see what she does. See, Maddie would have say it was once Peggy's old ones that mother, Maddie's mother had tried to disguise with new trimmings. So no one in room 13 would recognize it. And she has to, means Peggy used to give dresses to Maddie, and if Peggy will ask who, how do you get those dresses, then Maddie has to give the answer that Peggy gives me that, and my mother used to do some repairing and altering things, and then I used to wear it. So if only Peggy would decide of her own accord to stop having fun with Wanda, oh well. Maddie ran her hand through her short blonde hair, blonde means what, very golden hair, as though to push the uncomfortable thought away. What difference did it make? Slowly Maddie tore into bits the notes she had started. She was Peggy's best friend, and Peggy was the best liked girls in the whole room. Peggy could not possibly do anything that was really wrong, she thought. And then she thought that, okay, I will write the letter, and then she understood that suppose Peggy will take Peggy will take the revenge, then what will happen? So she stopped doing that, and then she thought, okay, Peggy is not that cruel girl which will who will trouble more to her. As for Wanda, she was just some girls who lived up to on Boggins' height and stood alone in the schoolyard. She scarcely ever said anything to anybody. The only time she talked was in the schoolyard about her 100 dresses. And you know that what is the nature of the Wanda? That Wanda was a very quiet girl. She was very, talking nothing to anyone else. When Peggy used to ask question to Wanda, that time only she used to say about the dresses and all. So otherwise she used to keep herself very shut. And she remembered another that was a brilliant jingle green with a red sash. You'd look like a Christmas tree in that, the girls had said in the pretended admiration. And when she said that I have that dress and that date, that time all the girls were making fun of her, and that all remembered by the Miss Maddie. Thinking about the Wanda and her 100 dresses all lined up in the closet, Maddie began to wonder who was going to win the drawing and coloring contest. And now she was in that particular mood to think about the Wanda and all, and suddenly she understood, she just strike that I have to participate in the coloring contest, and who will win that? So for girls, the contest is considered by designing dresses, and for boys, and what was the contest? For the boys, designing motorboat, and for girls, dresses or designing motorboat. Probably Peggy would win the girls' medal. Peggy drew better than anyone else in the room, and Maddie supposed that Peggy will win the contest because she is very, very great in writing the or drawing the sketch. At last, that was where everybody thought. She could copy a picture in the magazine or some film star's head, so that you could almost tell who it was. Miss Peggy used to draw some sketches of some magazine heroes and heroines or some other thing. And we can understand, okay, this is a picture of particular thing, particular person. So that much she was capable of sketching. That is why everybody knows that Peggy will win the contest. Oh, Maddie was sure Peggy would win. Well, tomorrow the teacher was going to announce the winners. And then they would know that Peggy will be the winner. That was the, you know, possibly granted thing. The next day, it was drizzling. Drizzling is what? A very light rain was falling. Maddie and Peggy hurried to school under Peggy's umbrella. Both, because by this sentence also we can understand that Maddie doesn't have her own umbrella also. So she has come in the under umbrella of Peggy. By this, you can understand Maddie was a very poor girl. Naturally, on a day like this, they didn't wait for Wanda Pentronsky on the corner of the Oliver Street. The street was far, far away under the railroad track, and up the hill led to Boggins' height. Anyway, they weren't taking chance on being late today, because today was the important. And you know that every day, usually they used to wait for the Wanda to make fun of her. But today, as it was raining very, you know, slightly, so today they don't want to wait there and make fun. And also they wanted to go very hurriedly to school, because today their teacher was about to announce the result. Do you think Miss Mason will announce the winners today? Asked Peggy. Oh, I hope so. the minute we get in, said Mary, of course you will win Peg. And you know that Mary used to call her Peg because they were very close friends. And she said, yes, of course, maybe teacher will announce. And Mary suggested that you will be winner. She said, of course, maybe to see. The minute they entered the classroom, they stopped short gas. There were drawings all over the room, on every ledge and window, still dazzling colors and brilliant lavish designs, all drawn on great sheet of wrapping paper. There must have been 100 of them all lined up. And as soon as they entered in the room, they saw that there were 100 pictures in the classroom of the dresses, properly lined one by another. These must be the drawings from the contest. Everybody stopped and whistled or murmured admiringly. This positively, all because all pictures were very, very good. They were very astonished by looking those pictures. As soon as the class had assembled, Miss Mason announced the winner. Jack Bagels had won for the boys. She has announced Jack Bagels, who won the prize from the boys for drawing motorboats, as he said, and his design for an outboard motor was exhibition in the room 12, along with the sketches by all the other boys. And she has directed that all the sketches which is given in the stuck in the room number 12. As for the girls, she said, although just one or two sketches were submitted by most of the girls and girl students have submitted one or two sketches, but one girl, and room number 13 should be proud of her, this one girl actually drew 100 designs. But she has said, Mrs. Mason has said, that okay, almost 99% of those girl students have submitted one or two pictures of the dresses. But one girl, and our whole room number 13 should feel proud about that girl, that one girl has submitted around 100 pictures of the dresses. In the opinion of the judges, any of the drawings is worthy of winning the prize. And there is not that that all pictures were very identical, very different, and all pictures were very, very, very precious one. So judges said that any picture can be get first rank. Among that, all 100 pictures. I am very happy to say that Wanda Petrowski is the winner of the girls' medal. And now she announced the name of the Wanda Petrowski, that she is the winner. Actually, Maddie thought that Peggy will be the winner, but now teacher has announced that Wanda Petrowski is the winner of the girls' contest. Unfortunately, Wanda has been absent for the school for some days and is not here to receive the applause that is due to her. And today she is not there, many days she is not there, and she didn't receive the admiration from our side. Let us hope that she will be back tomorrow. Now class, you may file around the room quietly and look at the exquisite drawing. It's very extremely beautiful, exquisite means what? Very beautiful drawing. The children burst into the applause. Wow, great pictures which is drawn by the Wanda Petrowski. Actually, before drawing the picture or sketches, the frame of mind about Wanda was very different. They were thinking this is a very, very poor girl. She doesn't have any other thing, positiveness and all. But now when they saw all the boys and girls have saw the pictures of which is drawn by the Wanda, they become so astonished. They become spellbound. The children burst into the applause, and even the boys were glad to have a chance to stamp on the floor, put their fingers in their mouth and whistle, though they were not interested in dresses. Even though boys are not interested in dresses, but they, after seeing those pictures, they become so, so happy, they become so astonished, amazed, and that is why they whistled. "Look, Peg," whispered Mary, there's that blue one she told us about. Isn't it beautiful?" "Yes," said Peggy. "And here's that green one, boy, and thought I could draw." And in this way, then Peggy also had admitted that Wanda has drawn very good sketches and all the things. So we can understand at the end, we can see that she said that once that she had 100 dresses. So these are the 100 dresses she has in her mind. She might have drawn, also we can think over, even though it is not given in the lesson, that she might have drawn the sketches of the shoes also. So she is a good artist, we can understand at the end. And now, at the beginning of the lesson, I have told you that this particular story has been written by the Esther in the certain guilt she has of her life. So, such type of girl like Wanda Petrowski was there. Not exactly Wanda Petrowski, but one girl, one classmate was there in her academy, in her childhood. And one girl used to tease her, but she couldn't go against that girl because that particular girl was her friend. So she couldn't, Miss Esther was, Esther couldn't go against that. And that guilt was there in her life, throughout the life. That is why she has made this story, she has written this story. So I hope that you understood the story. What we have understood in this story? We have understood this three character, Wanda Petrowski, who was not from the America, she is from the Poland, but she has immigrated to America. Then Peggy was a very good girl also. She is sensitive about the animals and all, but she used to make fun of Wanda Petrowski. Maddie, Maddie is one of the girl, one of the student of the classroom number 13, and she is very close friend to Peggy. She never teased Wanda Petrowski, but she always supported Peggy. But she has certain different opinion about the question which she used to ask, Peggy used to ask, how many dresses you have to Wanda Petrowski, but she couldn't dare because Maddie also was very poor girl and she was afraid that maybe one day same question will be asked to me by Peggy and that time I will get the matter of one for other class. So by this lesson what we have to understand, we should not judge any boy or any girl or any person in the society with the outer look. We have to understand his nature, we have to understand his quality and the other thing which is in character. So I hope that you have understood the lesson and you also you have got some message, very worthy message through this story. Thank you.